Hello and welcome back to Devoxx 2014. I'm here with Ludovic Champenois, and we're here to talk about something called ManagedVM. Ludo, welcome.
Welcome. Yeah, thank you.
And actually, ManagedVM is something I've heard about a long time ago. Mm-hmm. Well, not that long ago, but it's been in the works for a little while. And it kind of changes the game, I think, for App Engine users. So, or the people that looked at App Engine a while back and maybe it didn't fit their need. So maybe I think ManagedVM is a reason they should look at it. And of course, for everybody else, it opens new possibilities. So walk us through some of that.
Yeah, so ManagedVMs was launched last week in San Francisco. So it's brand new. Okay.
So everybody has access to this.
So everybody has access to it. Before, we were running a private trusted tester trial. But now everybody can try ManagedVM. And ManagedVM is really App Engine V2, or this is a new App Engine
2.0,
which is based on all the cloud platform feature that we launched over the last few years. So it's basically, you keep the App Engine model very simple, just work on your application, you deploy it and it scales automatically. We do failover, we manage for it.
Keep all the goodness of
App Engine. So you keep everything that was the value of App Engine as of we know it today. And then, in order to run in the old Google data centers, App Engine had to give you some restriction because you could not write to a file system, you could not use native code because guess what, with native code you can explore the environment. You could not call, you could not do.
Yeah, so for Java developers, there was a white
so
list of
So some
things you
people,
could do.
Yeah, were not very happy with this. And I agree, but you know, with value added on terms of the scalability of the platform, you had to give away a few features. So App Engine V2 or ManagedVM is exactly removing all those restrictions. So basically, you run a container. I mean, you have heard that. Devoxx this week, I mean, everybody's talking about containers.
It's kind of a trending thing, yes.
Yeah, so, I mean, a container is a new WAR format. It's a new unit of deployment, but it's not only Java, it's your unit of processing, whether it's a JVM or a JVM plus native code that you want to call because you want to access a native image library, for example, or a PDF generator, et cetera, et cetera. So you can keep the simplicity of App Engine, deploy it to a ManagedVM, and for example, use native code or AWT or all
the
those
things that were forbidden that you could not use before.
While upgrading to ManagedVM, we also upgraded from the servlet specification we are using in Classic, and now you can do servlets 3.1 with annotation, and we are extremely efficient in terms of processing those annotations at the SDK time, so before we deploy the container to the cloud. So ManagedVM is based on Compute Engine, so it's App Engine running on top of Compute Engine and running inside a VM. But instead of giving you pure access to the VM, we are running a Docker system inside this VM. So what you really develop locally on your desktop is a Docker image, so you test it with Docker containers. And then once you are okay, you can deploy it to the cloud using the same exact image you have been using.
Which is part of the value of Docker, is to be able to have the same exact environment in development and production, no longer, you know, it works on my machine. But walk us through a little bit for the developer what it means. Are they exposed to Docker as such on the client side?
So no. If you do nothing except that changing one line if you're in your App Engine web.xml, and the line is VM true, so you declare to the system, I want to run in a VM environment,
right?
Then the SDK will do will create the Docker image, instantiate a Docker container for you, and you don't really see, you are not exposed to Docker.
So the App Engine SDK or the cloud SDK actually, you know,
so same commands as before. You know, you run or you deploy your application, and underneath we will use a Docker system running on your desktop, and we will execute this Docker container for you. So this is the out of the box experience for App Engine V2 or ManagedVM. Right. One line in your code, and then suddenly you are running in the Docker environment. So now, once you are running in this Docker environment, we give you, again, access to the full JVM, but we give you access to other runtimes. So obviously, we have Java, Python, and Go, like
Even maybe
Classic.
More recent versions of Java?
Java 7, by out of the box, but if you want to start customizing those runtimes, you can as well, because you can edit a Docker file, which is a unit of description of what is your Docker container, and instead of downloading the OpenJDK 7, you can download JDK 8 if you want, or even JDK 9, or right. even your own build of JDK if you want.
Okay.
And this ManagedVM will run with this new JVM if you want.
So, but you were about to say that we can have also brand new runtimes.
So, of course, we can customize all the way a JVM running in this container. And we can also explore new runtimes. So for example, we have a custom runtime called Node.js. I guess Node.js is extremely popular for mobile developers, mobile backends.
Yeah.
And we kept the simplicity of App Engine. We provide JavaScript or Node.js App Engine APIs for data store, Memcache, TaskQueue. So all the APIs that are part of the App Engine ecosystem can be accessed from a Node.js application. And suddenly, you have a brand new runtime, but using the same unit of deployment, unit of execution and management in App Engine so that we can scale you to many more VMs, depending on the traffic you have.
So Node.js is even newer, so ManagedVM allowed for something like Node.js to
yes.
exist. This is something that Google worked on?
Yes,
that
so it's still beta, but we did all the API bindings for Node.js for App Engine. And you can use also Google Cloud APIs as well. So if you want to access cloud storage or MapReduce, I mean the big data capabilities of the cloud platform, you can also use that from a generic Node.js library that you add in your package.json to describe that you depend on it.
Okay. Any other runtime? I think Dart.
We have Dart as well because
as well.
Yeah, Dart has been very, very popular on the client side. And guess what? I mean, it's a full feature server side language as well. And the Dart team worked with us to deliver a Dart runtime for App Engine as well. And same, instead of using Java or Node, you use a Dart, but the Cloud SDK we are using for your local development is the same. Basically, it's just a Docker file saying, oh, I want to use a Java image, or I want to use a Node.js image, or a Dart image.
Okay, great. So, you know, I guess Google in the cloud is embracing Docker, obviously.
I mean, we are embracing containers. I mean, we have been using containers forever. App Engine in 2008 was running in a C group isolated environment in the cloud. We could not really talk about it, but this is how we were able to scale App Engine as we know it today. And the nice thing about Docker is finally the world and the entire world is recognizing that containers is the way to go. We are very happy that the Docker ecosystem is there because it's not only Google doing private technology, it's the entire community actively participating in the Docker ecosystem,
yeah,
which is great.
And Docker is hitting the sweet spot of talking, being relevant both to developers and to production.
Exactly.
And I think that's very
yeah,
useful.
I mean, this is the perfect model for the future of cloud for all the cloud providers.
And so you mentioned also that obviously Google is very invested in Docker. We're also investing in things on, I would say, on top of Docker, things like Kubernetes. But that is
A
subject of another interview we'll have soon.
Yeah, so I mean, we have a continuum from bare metal VMs to cluster management and then the other side of the spectrum, which is I only focus on my application, I deploy it, and Google, please do the management for me.
Yeah, and the scaling and the load balancing and all
and
that.
And from the those two extremes, you create a brand new VM to manage VM, we have a spectrum of capabilities and technology that you can, if you want, start using.
Right. So manage VM, now in beta, anybody can use it, try it out.
Yes.
I think if you've had looked at App Engine before, you probably should look at it again. It removes pretty much all of the restrictions you might have come across. So thank you, Ludo.
Yeah, thank you.
And looking forward to the feedback of people using that.